ஓகேவா? ஸோ திரும்பவும் நம்ம என்னென்ன பார்த்தோம் அப்படிங்கிறது பார்த்தா டிலே ஆகிட்டு இருக்கும். ஸோ வி வில் கண்டினியூ த ரிமைனிங் திங்ஸ். ஓகே, இஸ் த ஸ்க்ரீன் விசிபிள் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ்? ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ், இஸ் த ஸ்க்ரீன் விசிபிள்?
எஸ் சார்.
எஸ். ஓகே, so there are lot of string functions are there. Okay, so kindly understand, string functions mean we also lot of functions we discussed, like this one, len function, capitalize, title, uppercase, lower conversion, count function, find function, replace. Okay, these things we already discussed. Okay, so we are going to see some more functions. So kindly understand what is the purpose of these functions. Len function is used to count the number of characters. Okay, length of the string if you need means you can use len function. Capitalize will capitalize the first character. Okay, title function will convert every word's first character to capital letter. Okay, uppercase will convert entire thing to the capital. Lower case will convert entire thing to the lower case. Count function will count the particular character from the original string. Okay, it will count number of occurrences. Find function will find the particular substring in the original string. If it find means it returns the index position. If it not found means it will return -1. Okay, not found means always -1. Finding means it will display the exact location. Okay, then replace function, by using that you can replace your old words to new words. Okay, in your original string you can replace that. Okay, and some more functions are there, students kindly understand now. Index function. Okay, so you can give like this index of any character, it will return that particular location where it is present. Okay, students understood? It will check the particular string and will return the index value where the particular character present. Okay, so I will show you some more examples. So kindly understand and note down in your notes, students. Every function is very, very important. Okay, actually they won't ask directly, students. They will ask in the exam, like program or output based questions. Okay, so kindly understand the usage of every function. Okay, so if you want to find any index, particular index means you can use this index of g. I need the index of g. So anyone tell me what is the index of g, students? You can count manually and tell. Okay, so 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. 10 is the index value, so we can execute and see the index. Okay, see, it returns 10. 10 is the output. This is the particular character's index. Okay, but we already having another character g, but it will always return the first occurrence. Understood, students?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Then I will show you the count also. Count will count the particular character in the entire string and will return the number of occurrences of the particular character. Okay, so first here you can see two times the g is there, so I am using count function to count the particular character. Okay, so see here the same string, I am going to count the g. Okay, how many times the g is present? So we are having two times. Okay, so the count function will count the number of occurrences of the particular character. Okay, so then you can see there are a lot of functions to check the particular string is. Okay, this function, kindly understand students, al is alnum means is alpha numeric. Alpha means alphabets, numer means numbers. Okay, it is checking whether the string is combination of alphabets and numbers. okay, it may contain the numbers, alphabets, or both alphabets and the numbers. Okay, so for that we are going to see a lot of examples. So before that I will tell you everything. Next function is alpha. That is, a particular string should contain only the alphabets. Okay, if everything is alphabet, means it returns true, otherwise false. At least one number is present in the string means it returns false. Okay, then we are checking is lower. Is lower means this is not same as lower function. Students, don't confuse. Lower function means it will convert every character to lower case. Is lower means we are checking whether the particular string is all the characters are lower case or not. Okay, all the characters are lower means that returns true. Okay, otherwise it will return false. Okay, so is used to check. So it always returns only two output. One is true, another one false. Okay, depending upon the satisfaction, you will get either true or false. Then another function is numeric. That is, all the characters should be numbers. Then only it returns true. At least it found one character, that is alphabet, means it returns false. Okay, then is space. Is space means it checks all the characters are space. Okay, that is, a particular character is space or not. If it is a space, it returns true, otherwise false. Okay, then is title case. Okay, it's checking whether the particular thing is title case or not, that string. Then is uppercase or not. Like that we can check all the things. Okay, so first we will see all these functions. Okay, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 seven functions we are going to discuss now. Students, kindly see and note down all the things. Okay, so I'm going to use two three strings here. str2 equal to python 1 2 3, and str3 equal to 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, that is, everything is string, and we are going to use another string with full of capital. Okay, other letters are capital. Okay, then another string str5 equal to, that is, a space. Okay, so that's all. These are the five strings we are going to check now. Students, kindly see the output. Okay, first one, str1 dot is alpha numeric. Okay, so alnum is the function to check that particular string is alphanumeric or not. Alphanumeric means that string should contain only the alphabets and the numbers. Okay, the same thing I'm going to check with the second string also. Okay, the same function I'm going to use for second string, str1, str2. That is, two times I'm going to use. First time str1, second time str2. Then third time I'm using is numeric. Okay, str1. And again, I'm going to check the same function with str3. Okay, students, everyone following?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So the next one, I'm going to check str2 to is lower. Okay, is lower. That is, we are going to check all the alphabets are capital or small. Okay, so it will not bother about the numbers or special characters. It will check only the alphabets, that particular alphabets are small letter or not. Okay, so it will not check the numbers and special characters. Okay, so whenever you see the lower case and upper case, it will check only the alphabets. Then str4 dot is upper. So kindly follow it. All the things we are going to get either true or false. Okay, so then the last one, print str5 dot is space. okay, all the character should be space, okay, otherwise it returns false. Okay, we will check with any kind of examples. Okay, so I am going to use another one, that is a fourth string, again going to use by is space. Okay, so kindly see one by one, students. I am going to execute this, all the functions. So it checks first, is alpha numeric. Okay, so we are going to create five strings. First one, it returns false. Why it returns false, students? The first one we are going to check with alpha numeric. Why it returns false, students? Anyone? Alphabets or numbers. Okay, but this string contains the space in between this. Okay, the space means that is not in the case of alphabets or numbers, so it returns false. Okay, by the same way you are checking this one without any special characters. Okay, we are having only alphabets and numbers. If you check this ones, str2, it returns true. Okay, so here we are not having any special characters or space, so it returns true. Understood? But in the first case, you see there is a space, that is what it returning false. Okay, then next one is numeric. Is numeric also returns false, because every character should be numbers. Actually it's not like that. And if you check the str2 also, it returns false only, but we are checking str3, all the characters are numbers, so it returns true. Okay, then str2 we are checking is lower. Okay, so all the alphabets are lower, so it returns true, right? Then next one, str4 is upper. Again we are checking with str4, all the characters are uppercase, so it returns true. Okay, so depending upon the condition, it returns true or false. Kindly understand. So then fifth one, str5 dot is space, all the characters are space, so it returns true. Again we are checking with str4, everything a character, so it returns false. Is space means all the characters should be space, or you are checking the character that should be a space. Okay, understood, students? Students understood or not? These are the functions used to check the particular string is alphanumeric or numeric or lower case, upper case, title case. Anything you can check with this is conditions. Students understood? Students respond me.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So kindly note down, students, this example. Kindly note down. Can you take the screenshot and note it down later? Okay, so we go for the next one. Still we are having lot of functions. Okay, the split function also we already saw, right? And L strip, R strip, a strip is there. Okay, so actually what is this L strip, R strip? Means we can cut the characters. Okay, we can remove the leading characters. L means leading characters, R means trailing characters. Okay, leading means, so L means left side, R means right side, that's all. Okay, strip means it will check the both side, wherever it matches it will remove those characters, okay, from both the position. Okay, so that we will see now. L strip, R strip, left side strip. Strip means removing the characters. Okay, L means left side, R means right side. Okay, so left side means nothing. So from this side, okay, starting from this one, we are going to check and remove. Right side means from this side. Okay, from backs, that is called right side. So I'm going to use this one, str3.lstrip. Okay, L strip from left side. I'm going to remove the characters 1, 2, 3. Okay. So then again I'm going to use the same method, but I'm going to use the second string str2. If I use L strip, means what will happen? The same characters L strip from the left side, actually it's not present, so it will return the exactly the same output without a stripping, without removing any character. It will return all the same characters of the str2. Okay, but if I use R strip, means it will check from the right side and it will remove all the characters. That is 1, 2, 3 is present there, so it will remove from the right side. Okay, and you can also use strip command, that we are not mentioning the side of the checking. Okay, so it will check automatically both the sides. Wherever the character matching, it will remove all the things. Okay, for example, I will give here str4 123 computer 123. Okay, so if I use now this print str4 dot strip, okay, just only one strip, we are without mentioning L or R, okay, left side or right side. If I use this 123, means it will remove all the characters. That is 123 matching from both the sides. Okay, automatically it will check both the sides and remove. Okay, so we will see the output. So first we are going to create all the 5 strings. First we are going to use L strip method. Okay, L strip, you can see L strip str3 dot L strip of 123. Str3 means this one, str3 12345. We are going to remove 123. So it returns only the remaining character 45. Okay, it returning only the output 45. Understood? Then the next one, str2, that is in this one. From left side we are going to check. So left side there is no 123. Okay, that is a, it should be a beginning characters. Okay, so actually no 123 there. So it without removing, it returns entire characters. Okay, then again we are using R strip method. So it will check from the right side whether the particular characters are present. If it present, means it will remove and print the remaining characters. So from the right side, it is removing 123 and printing Python. Understood, students? It's stripping from the right side, removing the trailing characters. Understood, ma? Students? But the last method, you can see without using left side or right side, we are directly using strip method. It will check both side and removes all the matching characters. Okay, so we are using str4. So now you can see the string 123 computer 123. So I'm going to execute. So it removes 123 from both the side. Okay, left side also, right side also, it removing a 123 and returns the remaining characters. Students, understood?
Yes, sir.
Students, understood? Kindly note down these examples. Okay, so L strip, R strip, that is a L strip means it removes the trailing characters, that is from the left side. R strip means it will remove the mentioned characters from the right side. Okay, strip means it will remove the characters from both the sides simultaneously. Okay, the same time it will remove both the sides. So the next we will see end with, start with. Okay, we are going to check the particular string is ending with that particular character. Okay, so see here, it ends with it ending with this particular character or not. Okay, we are going to check that. Okay, so str3 is ending with ng or not. Okay, we are going to check that. The same thing I am going to use for the first string. Okay, str1. Okay, actually str3 is 1 2 3 4 5. It is not ending with ng. Okay, it will check, it is checking whether the particular string is ending with this character or not. Okay, if it is ending with the same mentioned character, means it returns true, otherwise false. So this one, if failing the condition, so returns false. This one satisfying and returns true, because this str1, see here, this end with the ng. Okay, so and we can also check the starting characters. Okay, whether the particular string is starting with these characters. Okay, so see str.2 starts with, these are the functions to can, you can check whether the particular string is starting with these characters. Okay, pyt. Okay, if it is not matched, means it will return false. Okay, this is another two functions. So see, we are going to create again all the five strings. First we are going to check str3.ending ends with. Okay, see, it is not ending with ng, so it returns false. Okay, next we are checking with the first string. Here again we are checking with ng, as it is satisfied, so it returns true. Okay, then str2 we are going to check here, but by using starts with, that is a starting with, this string is starting with a pyt or not. Okay, actually it is satisfying, so it going to return true, but we given the string wrong here. Str2, I given only st2. Okay, so it produces an error, name error. Okay, so I'm going to execute. See, the last one starts with, it satisfies and returns true. Okay, students, understood? Everyone, starts with, ends with, these functions, everyone understood or not?
Yes.
Students, respond me.
Yes.
All right, so kindly note down these functions and do some practice. Okay, so then remaining functions, there are a lot of functions there, but you can easily understand. Okay, so you can see here, find function we already saw. Rfind is another function that actually will search the particular string from the right side. Rfind means from the right side. I told you that find function. Okay, so that I will execute now also. The find function will find the substring in the original string and returns the first occurrence. That is the lowest index value. Okay, but rfind will return the highest index value. Okay, so see, find, I am going to find from the str1, I am going to find g. Okay, whether g is present or not. Okay, the same thing, I am going to search the particular character using rfind, same string str1 find, that is rfind. Okay, the function I am going to use rfind. Okay, so this find function will check from the starting position and returns the first matched occurrence of, that is like a lowest index. Okay, actually g is present two times. The first function will return the index of this one, and rfind will check from the right side. So if it matches with, means it returns the first character from the last, okay, index of the last one. So we will check. The first one returns a 10. Okay, that is the index of first G. But next one, it returns the index of rfind, means it returns of the last one. Okay, 17. Understood? That is a simple difference. Okay, so these are the things you can use it in your programs. So depending upon the requirement of your program, you can use any kind of functions. So kindly understand and do some practice. Okay, students, kindly you go through all the materials. I shared you both the material, that my material and the learn by example material. Okay, so kindly go through everything and do some practice. And if there is any doubt, kindly ask me. okay, don't waste the time, kindly do practice, you can do now also. That's it about today's class. Okay, we almost completed all the functions. Okay, and from tomorrow we are going to discuss by the programs. Okay, I will give you the program name, you should say which method we have to use. Okay, we have seen lot of methods. Okay, so this everything is a method. Students, function is also called methods. Split function, strip function, is numeric, is space, is title. So everything we are going to use. So kindly know all the functions. You should remember everything. When I am asking students, you have to tell which method we have to use for the particular program. Okay. So kindly understand and do practice. That's all about today's class. Thank you, everyone. Thank you. See you in the next class. Thank you, students.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, thank you.